How are we doing, everyone?
Hopefully, everyone is good. It is a push session. We are joined with Comrade. Is Comrade in frame?
Not too sure how wide the lens is, you see, so I'm not too sure how much it is there.
Anyway, we're joined by Comrade. Comrade is one of my clients. I've coached him for, I say client, he's a good friend. Like, I feel like a client.
Good friend,
is a,
client.
Yeah, we get on well. I've coached him for like 3 years at this point. And I've said to Comrade already about three times today that his chest isn't the best.
Pretty much every check-in, just...
Every check-in, it's...
More chest.
More chest.
Everything else is sound, just more chest.
Good, just your chest is just not responding. So basically, a few weeks back, Comrade jumped in with me for this session, and it kind of aligns where we're going to be making a few tweaks. So yeah. Comrade's probably going to be jumping in like every other week or every couple of weeks, just so I can kind of go through a chest session with him. Either way, today, we're just going to be running through my current push session. I'm only doing chest and delts one time per week right now. Once I'm back from my holiday, which I go away on Wednesday, so a few days from now, and pretty much once I'm back, I'm going to assess recovery capabilities. I might look to bump up chest volume or chest frequency to twice per week. But currently, we are 4 weeks to the day, pretty much, no, 4 weeks tomorrow from like post-show. So I'm still in that kind of post-prep phase. Body weight's slowly been rising up, which is good. I still am objectively probably a little bit behind of where I need to be from like a recovery standpoint. But at the same time, I'm not rushing. I feel good. I'm happy with how things are looking. Performance is rising rapidly. So today is the third rotation of this session. So I've got baseline numbers, week one, week two numbers after the baselines. And it's actually just gonna be a case of assessing, seeing how things are. This session isn't too demanding for me. I do need more chest. My delts, I don't really need too much of. I think if anything, I don't need more side delts. So actually, the format of this session is a little bit different from what I've ran in my previous off seasons. Starting out with a machine fly, two total working sets. I leave a rep or so in reserve. So Reese Fit doing RIR. Oh, Jesus
Not
Christ,
good.
What the hell? And then we actually go into the pressing work. Three presses today, reverse band, low incline Smith. We then have the Atlanta shoulder press and then the prime incline press loaden in the mid to lengthen range. Evo's got some real good pressing kit, so we are at Evo in Leicester. I've trained at this gym for a couple of years at this point, so the long-term OG subscribers would have seen this session before, seen this gym, not this session. So yeah, we're gonna get through it. We'll kind of talk a bit. We just had our machine stolen, which is not good. So we'll leave it there. I'm gonna have to say to him, but we had a few sets there. Can we jump in on the machine we're already on? But it's our fault, my fault at all. So yeah, all good. Chest up. Yeah, lovely, 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 lovely. Elbows in and across. Yeah, nice, mate. Good. Yeah, leave it there for that set. Good.
Sam, is it carrying on? Is it rolling?
Right, so something you'll notice, or hopefully you'll notice, I say it to Comrade throughout the set.
Execution.
Scapula, keeping it consistent. You don't want to be moving through too much through the scapula. When you do, it's just going to allocate a little bit more to the front delt. So we don't want it all the way pinned back. Some people it just feel better. I like almost like 70 to 80% retraction.
Good to find a balance in it.
Yeah, exactly. Some people prefer it naturally being like pinned all the way back. In my opinion, I don't think it feels amazing that way. You want to have some movement through the shoulder, obviously, but at the same time, you don't want to be, let's say, actively contracting and pushing your shoulder blades forward, and as a result, just activating a lot of your front delt. And the main goal is going to be to get the humerus elbow across the midline, and likewise, getting the pec fully short. Very easy on the fly to think just about hands, and your hands are absolutely irrelevant. I've said this multiple times before. So, two sets as mentioned, we're leaving a rep or two in reserve. We're just thinking about the quality and getting some blood flow and connection to the actual pecs. In my opinion, like, you could get this really, really strong. It's a pec fly. Get strong presses. That should be the main goal. So we're not trying to absolutely obliterate our chest. We're just doing two sets. For me, I'm going to go a little bit heavier on the second set. For Comrade, I reckon probably
a bit lighter.
Yeah, maybe one or two pins lighter and just go from there. So yeah, we're in sync already today. Comrade said one or two pins. I said one or two pins. We know it. Yeah. So, exercise number one. We haven't got it set up currently, but we are doing a reverse banded low incline Smith machine press. Now, this exercise is chosen just based off the resistance profile with the reverse band and the fact that when it comes to what we both need, upper chest development is always going to be something that I think a lot of people need, but myself and likewise Comrade need. So this is the first main press. We're reverse banding to initially pretty much get the most out of the pecs in that shorter range. As the band kicks in, pretty much what's going to happen is the band's obviously going to take out tension in the lengthened and therefore result in a greater challenge to get the pec short. The pec is pretty much fresh, yeah. We've done two sets on the fly, but it's two sets. So we're doing this the first main press. We then will pretty much actually have as the last press, the prime incline press, which we can actually manipulate to lower the lengthened. So
almost exercise, the opposite.
Yeah, so. Exercise mechanics 101 relative to resistance profiles and how fatigue picks up during a session. So yeah, first exercise, two sets here. I did 3.5 plates last time for, I think it's a 7. I have to look at my logbook, but I'll probably take a slight load progression depending on how things feel. So maybe 3.75, maybe 3 plates, a 5 and a 2.5. But either way, at this point of where I'm at, I'm just taking small micro loads here or there. Not trying to rush, just based on the fact I won't be able to. I can't, my body is not yet primed to just rush and add loads of load. But at the same time, every session, feeling better, feeling stronger. So we'll see how things go for Comrade. We'll see a bit over 2.
I think we did 2.5, I think, last time.
So, yeah.
Maybe 2.5, 2.5. Yeah. Just seeing.
See how it looks, see how it feels. If you want to get the bench set up, I'll do this.
Do you want this bench or?
I did this bench last time.
Yeah?
Yeah, so that one.
Yeah. I almost attach it to this. I hook this in there and then just attach that to the.
Should maybe listen to you, coach.
Yeah. This is why my chest is not the best. So I actually don't know how to do the movement, start the movement off. That is, might be an issue.
I think we had this in and then you just took it out randomly. You did something else, so.
They've got a prime piece, I thought, might as well just hop on there.
We're gonna do a reel about like long-term coaching, and in reality, like just don't listen to your coach. And then when it comes around, like Comrade's like, how do I set the band up? I'm like, bro, don't we do this exercise? And you're like, no.
Just log random numbers on the sheets,
to be fair, like. Different.
Right. If you progress at the end of the day, you sound.
I don't think you're going to get it exact every time with a bench and the lifting anyway.
You should. If you're not, then you're a bit of an idiot. Like, think about how would you not be able to get it set up properly? Bench stays the same, that stays the same.
Yeah, well, we clearly can't do it.
No, I just want it kicking in, like, in that mid-range. The one thing I hate about bands is when it's changed every week, because it just gives an inconsistency. And that is one pet peeve. I don't know if it's rolling, but when someone has a band set up and it's fucking different every single week, like you can't track progression, which is literally what's happened here because the band setup's a little bit odd. So yeah, jump on, see how that looks. Again, that's gonna kick in way too late.
Nah, we'll see.
Playing around with it. A few things to pay attention to. So obviously, we touched upon the band kicking in. Ideally, you want it kicking in that kind of mid-range. This is maybe a smidge high, but with how the daisy chain is set up, you're not ever going to find the absolutely immaculate and perfect setup when it comes to daisy chaining and reverse banding. And then also pay attention to the actual band tension being applied. The green band is pretty aggressive, like it's obviously pretty strong. In most situations, you want to almost match how strong you are relative to the band tension. So I would say most people would be better off, like let's say, with a purple band. But as you get progressively stronger, the band needs to be applied to a greater extent, or the tension needs to be to a greater extent. So I'm more so thinking long term, like this will be close to 4 plates within the next 2 or 3 rotations. It'll be up and above 4 plates within probably 5 rotations. So ideally, I don't want to be changing the bands as I go throughout my next push-up phase. So starting off with a green band, I've used a green band before. How you can usually tell is on that last rep. So if you were to, let's say, skip ahead, so skip through the video, find the top set, watch the last rep. If the rep is very, very slow, the concentric speed is extremely slow, and I don't need a bit of help, let's say, from Comrade, I've got the band set up pretty much spot on. If it's where I come out of the lengthened and I die, the band tension probably isn't too good. It's probably either giving me too much or likewise too little. So it's one of those, once you find a good setup, you want to keep it consistent. I touched upon it earlier. One thing that annoys me is when the band tension is different every single week because you don't know if you're progressing. It might be where 1 week the band's giving you more, 1 week the band's giving you less. For Comrade's overall load, he probably doesn't need the green band, but he's training with me, so we're not swapping around. It's just, again, like, Comrade can lose out on some progress. I don't care. Like, I'm not his coach. Right, 3 plates. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Yep, warm in.
Yeah, you
can. Cool.
Yes, good.
Gave me a little bit too much on the last one.
Do you think?
Yeah, like, it was a good spot, but it's probably a bit too
much. A little bit too much.
Yeah, a little bit less. Because the band's already held.
Yeah, I forgot about that, to be fair. That's why I stopped as soon as I saw it flew.
Yep. Yep.
Connor. Lovely. Really good. Nice, mate. Good. Yes. Good, Conrad. And again. Lovely. Lovely. Good. Yeah, nice. Work. Shouldn't have checked your eccentric on that last rep, wasn't like we're completely different.
Too slow?
Yeah, like you went into that with no belief. I gave you the slightest bit on that fifth rep, and in reality, like your eccentric
should
was
have
completely different.
What, attacked it a bit more?
Yeah, have some belief. Like your fourth, your first, second, snappy. Third, fourth sound, and then on your fifth, you were like, and then you like almost paused it.
Yeah.
There shouldn't be that dramatic change. I'll do three plates.
Five.
And I'll do three plates. I'll do a high-ish rep. No, actually, I'll go heavier. Three plates and a five.
Yeah.
Three, two, one. Yep.
Come on. One, two, easy. Three, yes. Four, five, six, good, come on. Seven, yes. Eight, come on, two more, easy. Nine, yes, yes, come on. 10, yes. For 11 then, come on, come on. Yes!
Woo. Sick, that was good. I can train, wow. That was good.
11.
I'll take that.
Didn't even touch last as well.
No, of course.
Sorry, man.
Very good, two sets there. Three plates and a five for 11, so double figures. I got 11 on three plates, so 5 kg upside rep maintained. 3.75 for the top set. I think for 4 and 1, might have been 5 and 1. Have to VAR it, aka check the video, which was 5 kg up the side. Again, so 5 kg up on both sets, and both sets felt really good. So yeah, no complaints.
Both moved good as well.
Yeah, both move well. Like we did this session 2 weeks ago, and it's completely different.
Yeah.
I was nowhere near.
Stability, elbows everywhere.
Yeah, I was nowhere near that stable. And internal feel as a result, and my pecs feel really full. So
just from a powerful standpoint as well, like everything better, isn't it?
Everything better. Everything better. Coming back to life. One carbohydrate at a time. So all good. From Conran, he did two plates. I think he did 2.5 kg up. With Conran, the importance of his elbows. He's very delt dominant, as mentioned. So it's literally a case for Conran to almost think to really keep his elbows tucked. And actually keep the tension through the chest, because he literally just starts to protract his scapula, as mentioned on the pec fly, and then just presses through the front delt. And cool, his delts are good. His chest needs to be better. So elbow position, scapular position, and maintaining that sort of internal brace throughout the set is the most
important.
Just
staying accurate throughout, rather than just, because obviously I used to press 4 and a 10 on the shoulder press.
Yeah.
I'm pressing now maybe 3 and a 5, but obviously it would be in this video.
Yeah.
And the accuracy is so much better, like my front delts, upper chest feels so much better from dropping the load and actually
making sure to press off, press off the musculature that we're trying to
rather train. Than just loading moving the joints weight. Up at the end of the day, rather than...
There's definitely times where moving weight from point A to point B is beneficial. Like, you training is just getting stronger in adaptations, but it gets to a point where, especially in bodybuilding, you look at a physique and it's like there's clear gaps and clear holes and clear things you need to be better at. And if you're just chasing load and your physique stay like there's the weaknesses are staying there.
You need to make adjustments.
You have to make changes. So with Conran recently, the last probably 4 months, 5 months, we've been really, really meticulous with his training. We assess pretty much everything we can imagine that you could look at when it comes to pressing execution. Is he using less load? Yes. But has he actually ever had this level of musculature across his pressing? Musculature? No.
Across the board, really, as well.
Yeah, across the board. So, yeah, we're in a good spot. We're in a good spot. Power. Air in and go. Air in and go. Yes. Finish that. Yeah, a little bit. Solid.
Oh, yes.
Solid. Rush into those last few a bit. Those last few.
You think?
I know, you didn't brace. You should have got to the top fully.
Hard to find a balance between snappy and not rushing. And that's the best two faces.
It looked good, just you got a bit too over-eager.
Yeah.
But it's sound. It was a good set. Numbers-wise, sound.
What was it?
On a last rep, would you really think like just locking out, giving yourself a second and then going again?
Yeah.
You said you were like just dropping into them. You know, and like there was a few reps where I said don't drop too deep. Because you came like all the way down to your chest.
And came shallow.
No, you didn't come shallow, you just came too deep. Like you dropped into it like way too deep.
Yeah.
Again, like that's not going to be beneficial. All right, grab the plates, take them over to the shoulder press. No. Cool. Okay, so second press. I'll let Conran jump on, get a warm-up set done. We are using the Atlantis shoulder press, opting for the more neutral grip, the closer grip. I'm a big fan of the shoulder press, it's really good. I like to have it a little bit more of like a higher incline. I personally am not a massive fan of performing this as like a direct vertical shoulder press, just the alignment, how it feels, like it doesn't really seem to suit me or many people. So we're intentionally going to place our hips a touch further forward, really try and have that kind of higher incline trajectory. We're going to still bias the delt. This is a vertical press, but with the angle that we're pressing at, it's still going to be a good amount of upper chest. Likewise, it's going to be a good amount of upper chest in any shoulder focus press, any vertical press. But with this, intentionally, we're setting this up as like not a completely vertical press. It's a slight bit more of a higher incline. So two sets here. If you think about the first exercise, that's going to be more so upper chest predominant with a good amount of front delt. This is more shoulder dominant with a good amount of upper chest. A slightly different trajectory.
Swap them around a bit.
Yeah, just kind of ticking boxes. Something I've always explained on, let's say, training videos is like you want to look at your sessions and almost go step by step, box to box, and what you need, what your physique needs, and what the session demands, and literally work your way accordingly to those demands based off where you're going through the session. So, like I said, we've already done an upper chest focus press. We're now, like I say, challenging the shorter range. We're now challenging the delts, and then we're going to go back to the upper chest, but we're going to challenge the lengthen range. So, again, science, mechanics 101. So, for me, I'm going to do 4 plates of warm, and then heading at like 5.5, I did 5 plates last week.
I see you let you come your elbows quite wide. Do you think I should try that or just keep them narrow? Or?
Do how you've been doing it, mate. It's been working. Yeah. I wouldn't change it, just based on how it looks for me. If you look, let's say, at my hand position relative to my elbows, it's pretty much in line.
Yeah, exactly.
So if you think about, let's say, my shoulder probably being a bit wider.
If your
clavicles are wider, you're probably going to have to manipulate your elbow position.
Because I can, if you can come narrow.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Like if this looks feels well awkward for me. It looks awkward.
But in a couple of inches further.
This is more natural to me. And we always want to be as natural as possible.
Wherever you're falling, it really.
You always want to be natural, guys. We want to be natural as possible. Sound? Feel good?
Easy first weight. Come on. Yeah, easy. Good. Yeah, good. Yeah, 6 is there. Come on. Yes, yes. Yeah, you.
Ooh, yes, I'll leave there. Lovely. Woo! Ah, that was good. Happy that last rep. Yeah. Right, guys. So, a 4-week post-show. prep update, even though I'm not in prep. Really, really good. Everything is moving forward at the rate that it should be. Body composition, still in a very, very good spot. Just a smidge over 100 kilos. I'll put up my like baseline food and where things are. There's actually been no changes since the last time that I would have done a like post-prep update. So we initially established almost like a baseline level of food, and that's just been slowly and steadily climbing body weight-wise at about a kilo to, ideally about a kilo and a half per week, but it's actually been slightly less than that. But then the implementation of off-plan meals intentionally for more so social occasions and stuff like that, and actually enjoying a bit of flexibility has intentionally been put in. But right now, body weight's, like I said, smidge over 100 kilos, still a little bit under my men's physique stage weight, and as a result, like I'm still like pretty lean, but I feel a lot better, training performance is better. Unfortunately, I did a sex drive update last time. Sex drive, still not there. Sleep's better though, so that's positive. And in general, like my general demeanor and how I feel in and out of the gym is so much better. So for 4 weeks post-show, in a really, really good spot, all things considered. Still not 100%, but I imagine within the next week or two, I think things will be in an even better position. I go away on Wednesday, so a nice holiday. That'll be aligned with a little bit of a mini deload, so probably a few days worth of just chilling out. And then from that point, I'm gonna get some bloods done, assess health, and then kind of make the next sort of call, which will be outlined on the next video. So yeah, exciting time. Soon to actually be wanting to grow some muscle. So yeah, hopefully it actually shows. Hopefully I grow some muscle, so that'll be good. I'll brace. Bigger brace. Come on. Yeah, lovely. And again. Come on. Yes, mate. Come on. Good. Go for one. Your rep if you brace well. Yeah, lovely. And again. One with me. Come on. Haven't helped. Finish that. Want that rep. Want it. Yeah. Fucking good work, man. Fuck happened there, bro? That's good. Really good. Ooh. Even if you like danced a little bit on the last rep.
Yeah.
A little bit of a Ronaldinho side to side.
Trying to improve my skill star rating.
It was a good set, mate. What was that?
Felt very fucking good.
First rep flew. Like, it looked really good.
Whenever it does, the confidence just shoots right up, don't you?
Yeah, but you need to have that confidence.
Yeah, across every set.
Yeah, across every set. Because you went into that and like there was intent there.
Yeah.
It was a good level of intent.
Yeah. I think obviously training on your own is sometimes can be hard to do that though, isn't it? Sometimes.
It's one of them. But then, like, you know when the weight's there and it's like you should be having that confidence. Like you should be going in thinking, I'm going to get after this. You know, granted, you've had an extra day's worth of recovery, you know, from when you
feeling
were usually
fresh.
You know, feeling fresh. But like at the same time, like that's one of those where when that's there, you should be taking that set. And that should be like, if you imagine when that's not, like you don't even see it. And you're like, oh, I was just going on what I did previously.
Yeah, exactly.
You're missing out on so much opportunity. So yeah, it was a good set.
Yeah, easy. 2, 3, 4, easy. Yes. 6, come on. 7, come on. Yes, 8, come on, little bit.
Yes. Oh, Sam, that was a bit audacious, but I'll take that. Oh, I only got that for 7 as a top set. Like, so 8. Yeah, I'll tell you that.
8 for a back off, not bad.
Yeah, 8 for it, I'll tell you that. When I said 10, I was like, eh, we'll see. Oh, so 2 sets there, guys. 5.5 plates for a top set. 10 kilos up per side, which is good. I'll do 6 on that within the next 2 rotations, I'd imagine. And then 5 plates for the back off set, which was the top set last week, for an additional rep. So, not too bad. I said double figures before going in, but that was very audacious. Sometimes I say stuff that I know I'm not going to get, but it's just one of those that I go with confidence. You never know. So, yeah, 2 very, very productive sets there. No surprise. More of it to come.
Progressions on progressions.
Yeah, baby. What are you doing for your back off? Set 3. Yeah.
3.
No! Come on. Harry. Come on, big delts. Lovely. I shoot. Little bit. Good.
Oh, fucking hell.
Eccentric. Solid. Good man. Very good. Again, that's fine balance for you.
Yeah.
Because it's like the first 3 or 4 were so snappy, but not much control on the eccentric.
Yeah.
But it was still a good set. Like 3 plates for, what'd you get?
Upper.
What did you get this for a few weeks back? Like
5. 2 weeks, 5.
Doubled his reps.
Woo, not bad.
Yeah, good man.
That really felt good. Very good.
It looked good. Yeah, looked really good. Right, so that's shoulder press done. Two sets there, two very good sets. Quality is what's most important with this. And there, four sets that we've done so far that are really high quality. So, yeah, literally, not a lot to complain about. These are the sort of sets that you grow muscle upon. Like, do sets like this over and over and over and over, progression lifts. You'll probably turn out and you'll go, oh, my chest has grown, my delts have grown. That's literally it.
So, a little bit more loading reps at the end of the
day. Yeah, exactly. So, yeah. Not too bad, not too bad. We're now moving on to the priming climb press. As mentioned, loading in the mid to lengthened, just based on the fact that at this point of the session, four sets deep, I'm not sure about you, but my chest and shoulders are pretty fried.
Yeah, pretty fatigued. So,
yeah, probably just one set. I eventually will probably go to two sets on the prime incline, but I look at it and think that's an escalation protocol that I can put in when it's going to actually have benefit. Right now, like, if I tense my chest, tires, like, I don't think like two extra sets from this point is going to cause me much benefit. So just one set, it is still going to be a good amount of stimulus. I just keep the reps a little bit higher. So yeah, that's this done. We now move on to the next press. Cool.
Come on, elbows tuck, come on. Yes, yeah, good rep, good. Come on. Stay on it, stay on it. Yes, little bit, little bit. Yeah.
Ooh, lovely.
Yeah, good one.
My fucking hamstring. Oh, cramping. Oh, cool. Ah, good set though. 5 kg up on the middle pin there. So obviously touching upon load distribution, it's very easy to overcomplicate on prime. And again, similar to the bands, just changing stuff constantly. Ideally, we want, like, in my opinion at this point in the session, like a 60-40 split. So 60% of the load on the top pin, 40% on the middle pin. And I more so modulate the loading based off how the previous weeks went. So first rotation, I pretty much, from the first to second rotation, increased load on the top pin. This rotation, I kind of added a bit more load onto the middle pin just based off how the profile looked. I watched the video back from last week, the reason why video analysis is important. And I thought, right, a little bit more load in that middle pin, so therefore it's a bit more of a challenge because it was very, very, like, in a sense, the drop-off last week was just a little bit too much for my liking, but it was really heavy in that lengthened. So that felt really good, like probably the best that's been other than my hamstring cramping, which is a bit frustrating. Clearly, just need more Hydromax, CSN, Reese Fit 10, Hydromax, get it. So yeah, Conrad's gonna do his set. He's taking a slight load progression, just one set here. Like I said, this will go to two sets eventually, but for now, one more than enough. And that concludes the pressing work. So five total pressing sets, five sets progressed. Hopefully my chest grows. You'd hope so. Shoot, wait for the drop off, mate. Good. One, mate. Come on, last pressing bit. Come on, you'll recover from this, mate. Easy, easy. Drive, drive. Yeah, lovely, lovely. Big chest. Eccentric, eccentric. Don't fucking let it drop. Good. Solid. Woo. So, in conclusion to the pressing work of the session being done, if we're looking at this as like objectives of the sense of, or if we're looking at objectivity of how to grow a chest, execution, not chasing load, but also wanting to prioritize progressive overload when appropriate, we could look at exercise selection. Like I said, first exercise, challenging shorter range, second exercise, more delt focus. This exercise, back to pretty much the main intention of the session, our top line, but challenging the lengthened. If you obviously don't have a prime bit of kit, yeah, you might struggle, but exercise selection is absolutely imperative. And in a sense, just assessment. The amount of times that me and Conran will have a discussion regarding loading, you'll see on this video, like, what do you reckon we should do? Do you reckon we should take some high rep sets? For example, when it comes to leaving your ego at the door, something that Conran said earlier,
yeah,
she's chase load. So bringing the load down, stripping the load back.
Whichever feels better. Sometimes a high load set might feel better than a high rep up.
Yeah.
we'll just be dependent on the day, to be fair. Like, if you're feeling strong,
and
feeling
previous
good.
Rotations, previous data. Like, this is when logbooking is so important. Like, the logbook shouldn't be the main driver of just the thing you need to beat. We've all been there when we just tried to beat the logbook. But the logbook for data and assessment of how something's feeling and how something's moving is going to be very, very important. And likewise, video analysis. I said I looked at my previous sets and thought, how can these be better? And this is me literally a month after a prep where I could in theory be like, oh, well, my training's gonna get better just as a result of more food and more body fat. But even at this point, training we should be meticulous with. So that's five sets, and genuinely, my chest fried.
Very good, yes.
Yeah, like chest and my pressing musculature, done. So I'm now gonna do three sets of a lateral raise. It's the only lateral raise work that I actually do. I'm gonna just do literally a dumbbell lateral raise. I then have a little bit of triceps, and that's pretty much the session. Like, it's literally just main pressing work and then a little bit of top up work on the areas that are needed. Guessing you're probably just gonna do similar.
Yeah.
Like, all just pretty much in session together. So yeah, sound? All good. So, dumbbell lateral, if there's anything I probably don't need more of, it's side delt. I connect well with my side delts, therefore I'm doing a dumbbell lateral raise. I always connect well with this exercise. Three sets, I usually do one medium set, then I go for a bit of a, yeah buddy, second set. Okay, a little bit of body English, a little bit of a swing. And then I do a third set, usually back to the load that I've done the first set. And that's the way I like to do lateral raise. I only do three sets of lateral raise per week. Because I really don't need more side delt. I need this muscle to ideally go elsewhere. So yeah, Comrade's doing a cable lateral. If you're looking at mechanics, cable lateral makes more sense. But a dumbbell lateral, you connect well with, pretty time efficient. And or if you connect well with and they're time efficient, then sound, crack on. At the end of the day, it's a lateral raise. So yeah, three sets here.
Yeah, that's what I'd love to do.
Your arms are good. It's because your arms and delts are pumped.
So dominant.
Yeah, no, not dominant, just they're pumped. You pump them up at the end, so they're going to look fuller.
Yeah, because the last thing we did for chest was
right, Comrade, do your fucking posing. This is one thing that Comrade's got a bit of a tendency with. He poses and then has to talk after every pose, like a review. And I said to him throughout his entire prep, just go through the poses, bro. We'll have a discussion after. So our main goals and objectives, for people that don't know, Comrade competed last year. We took second in the UK for teens, which was good. And we won our qualifying show, and third at the BMBF, which was our first show. We did four shows in total, pretty much with the standard getting higher each one. And like our results were, we went for like a different look every single time, which was good. It was good to, for data. From that, like it was a case of getting his feet wet, assessing how, we knew heading in that like he was good for a teen, and he was good for a teen, but there were better teams, aka one better team, Josh Bogdani. Shout out Josh. So since then, it's been a case of heading into an improvement phase. We've made the transition to the enhanced side of things relative to Comrade's goals. So pretty much that results in PED usage, very, very minimal. We got bloods done. We pretty much ran 12 weeks at 180 milligrams a test, and then we've recently had our first bump up of androgens to 230, so pretty much an extra 50 milligrams a test per week. So literally his maximum androgen load is 230 milligrams, and he's currently sitting pretty much 20 kilos up from stage weight, which is pretty wild considering he's in very good nick. Is he shredded? No, but he's in a very, very good spot. And we're pretty much running like two high days per week on his weak body part days. The main areas to improve are his chest, his hamstrings, his glutes, And in a sense, just overall size, like Comrade's tall. Like I'm not that small, I'm about 6 foot. 6 foot one if I was to be in shoes and maybe stood up straight, but I'm about 6 foot. Where Comrade, like 6'3", 6'4". So as a result of that, he can look pretty imposing, but then when he gets shredded, his limbs look, look slim and skinny, because when you're that tall, your limbs are long. So it's literally a case of just overall development in every area. However, we are trying to add more meat onto his chest, onto his hamstrings, onto his glutes. But then at the same time, there is that whole systemic development of what we're looking for. And like I said, we'll probably hit, I'd like to imagine, 105 to 110 kilos as an absolute minimum in this push-up phase. And if I'm honest, I reckon we'll see 120 before he steps on stage again. Like that'll be probably peak off-season 120, which will be exciting considering his peak weight prior. Like he started prep at, he was 113 kilos, but he was a fat mess. And he started prep at like 103, 104, and you were a lot softer than what you are now. So yeah, genuinely, it's been a really exciting project. And this is gonna segue nicely, once Conrad gets changed, into the reel that we're gonna post that might be on the YouTube video as well regarding pretty much long-term coaching, because it has been a long-term project with Conrad. So, but that was pushed, very good session. Really nice, like I said, to go through a session with Conrad and just kind of assess, and if anything, just like have a bit of fun, but then at the same time, beat previous numbers and just get after it. Like it's always good, and that's the reason why I enjoy training with Conrad. I've coached him for such a long time. I know how he trains, and we vibe well off each other. We always get good sessions in, and I think this is going to be something that we'll probably try and keep consistent, like most Saturdays, every other Saturday, every third Saturday, when things and schedules align. So. That is the push session for me. Conrad, what did you think of the session? Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, very good session, to be fair. Regarding the first session we did, obviously Reese was setting baseline numbers, and I was swapping the sessions around a bit here and there. So mentally preparing for that session obviously wasn't all there, but doubling reps on the back off on the shoulder press, execution on that was a lot better. Incline Smith felt a lot better as well, and just in general, just a very good session. Like, no real complaints. Progress across the board. Felt good. Feeling good.
As it should be. Like, I think it's one of them. A lot of people overstate, like, oh, this should be changed, this should be changed. Comrade's a simple case of just turning up weekly and getting boxes ticked.
Yeah.
Like, your check-ins now are like, yep, sound, things are good, let's make a few tweaks here, and let's get better. Like, that's literally what it is. And that's what it's that's what it should be in an improvement phase. And there's no surprise, like, when I post photos of a Comrade, people will go, oh my God, like, I'll get loads of messages saying, like, he's blown up, he's done this, we've done that. But there's nothing magic to what we're doing. It's the basics, and Comrade doesn't really miss a beat, other than when his car doesn't decide to work or whatever, and then he can't get to the gym. Conrad missed a session. Was it two sessions?
I think that was the first session.
Was it two sessions?
Well, I didn't miss two sessions. I had 2 days rest. Ooh. I missed Wednesday's session, obviously, out Thursday off, so could call it a mini dino. That is potentially why we made so much progress today.
Yeah, because he had an extra day's worth of rest. Therefore, mate, 4 times a week. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing 4 times a week training. Anyway, we're rambling on. That's the session. That's the new push format with how things are set up for me. The next time we film this session, I'm guessing there'll probably be a fair few manipulations, more so for me. Conrad will probably be relatively similar if he's in for the session. But for me, there'll be probably a fair few more tweaks. So like I said, I go away on Wednesday. I'm away for 5 days. I've got my client competing, Jack Kelly, next Sunday, which will be exciting. I then fly away again on Monday. So I'm away for like 4 or 5 days, come back, fly away for a week. And then that pretty much is going to be almost like the start of the actual kind of gaining phase. This lasts like 4 to 6 weeks. Is pretty much just been get my health back into a good spot, get training back into a good spot, build my food up, and kind of reverse out of
adapt
a prep.
Adapt
to training again, and actually just getting myself primed. Coming out of a show, a long prep where you were lean for a very, very long time, and you pretty much kill yourself to get on stage, like towards the end, it's one of those where like I wasn't in a good spot to come into the gym and smash it. After my last prep, I was in the gym after a day or two, and I was training progressively. This is a completely different sort of setup because of how aggressive we were towards the end relative to actually stepping on a bodybuilding stage and wanting to be absolutely stripped. So yeah, it's one of them where I'm now in a better, far better position. I've laid the foundations for this kind of off-season push-up, and it's simply a case now of actually growing and ideally not having as many fucking veins and lines on my legs and quads and upper body and stuff. So actually getting a bit fat. So yeah, Reese fat pending. That's going to be the outro. So yeah, as always, guys, thank you for the support. Thanks for the story tags. Story tags mean ever so much. So if you are watching this, give me a story tag. That'll mean a lot. And likewise, all the support, shares, anything like that, please feel free. It helps me out. And yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed the video. Hopefully Conrad has been a good guest.
Hopefully many more to come.
That'll be that, guys. Catch you later. See you later. Bye-bye.
Awesome. Right.